Hi, I'm Dr. Abhinav Dhami, Consultant Cataract and Retina Services, practicing in Dhami Eye Care Hospital, Ludhiana, Punjab in India. I've been practicing my cataract and retina services for almost 10 years here. I have been lucky to use the M822 for almost 3 years now, and I should say that I've been able to do almost about 1,000 surgeries on it, or probably more, and it has been a wonderful experience till now. When we're using any microscope, the basic challenge is first is the conversion from to topical anesthesia from local anesthesia. Now, how that makes life a little difficult is when you have a lighting that's too bright for any patient or for the surgeon, the patient's response to light can hinder the surgery. Now, how the M822 helps is the ambient lighting. Now, secondly, what we need in this scenario is we need a retro illumination. The retro illumination allows us to constantly have a constant red glow. Well, even after we do the hydro dissection or hydro delineation, the retro illumination allows us to see the capsular part and make sure that our depth while we're putting any surgical instrument is correct. The transition or making a choice for buying the Leica was very easy for me. One, because I wanted better optics for myself while operating surgeries. Second, I wanted a microscope which gives me a good depth while doing the surgery. And third, the amicable lighting and the red glow. The constant red glow allows me to do any surgery or any grade of nuclear cataracts with ease. Second, it's easy to use and it's much more comfortable for doing surgeries. The M822 helps you in all scenarios. So when you're performing either cataract surgeries, corneal surgeries, and also retinal surgeries. Now again, as I said, the three things that come into hand. One is good optics, second is ambient lighting, and third is the in-depth analysis of every vessel you're touching or every part of the eye that you're operating on, it becomes easier. Now we talk about a lot of the red glow. The red glow basically means the reflex we get from the posterior chamber. Now, how and why it makes a difference? One thing is that when you're doing certain cataracts, in which especially even the denser cataracts, you do not realize when you're chopping the nucleus how deep you're going. And especially when you are doing a phaco salute or you're doing a first initial chop, the red glow helps you analyze where your instruments are. Now, we need a red glow almost all the time. And sometimes certain microscopes give you for a limited time or you have to change the settings. That doesn't happen with the Leica. With the Leica, the red glow is always there. Whether you're performing your first step, whether you're doing your capsular rexus, whether you're doing your nucleus emulsification, your chopping, or when you're doing hydro polish for the posterior capsule, which is very important because sometimes there are some remnant cortical fibers that need to be cleaned. Those cortical fibers, if not cleaned at the end of the surgery, can lead to early posterior capsular pacification. We don't want that. That is where the Leica comes in handy. You have a constant red glow, which can be managed from the settings as and how you want it to be. So go ahead, try it and tell me how you feel. Now that goes along with the motto that Leica stands for, eye to inside. That means whether you're operating on the outside, whether you're operating inside the eye, or whether you're going right behind the retina, you will have no problems in operating any of the procedures. All these equipments are expensive. Now, when you have to make a choice in choosing a microscope, I would suggest do a hands-on on all the microscopes. I can promise you, the moment you try on the Leica M822, you will not go wrong. The ease, the comfort, the lighting, the optics, the depth will win your hearts and your mind. A lot of us do think, no, we want to buy the most expensive of machines, we want to buy the most expensive of equipments. Let me tell you, if your microscope is not worthy of it, your outcomes of surgery will not be as good. Because if you can't see what's happening inside the eye, no matter how good of a machine you have, you can't run or you can't win the surgical cases. And for long-standing outcomes, you need a machine that is sturdy and worth standing for. Setting up a practice, it involves big bucks. It's not easy to buy all the expensive machines to have the best of equipment. Best of all of knowledge cannot be there in one shelter. Now, when we are trying to make a choice for microscope, I would really suggest choose the best one. The best one means the one that gives you the best of optics, the one that gives you the best of depth, and the one that allows you to perform your surgeries with ease, because you're going to be a surgeon for a long time and you can't have a microscope giving you problems. And I will want to tell you, it's not the machine that makes you a better surgeon. It's the surgeon who makes the better choices in buying better machinery and allows you to buy a good microscope, which will help you in the long way. Now, I don't say that you have to go ahead and buy a Leica on my word, but I would suggest try your hands on it, and I bet you that you will not want to choose anything else. That's my insight for you.